Hey, Adam Vavro here, and welcome back to another episode of Ask a Pro Anything, presented by Andro, the at-home edition. I've got two players with me that you might recognize. They're two of the top players in Africa. We've got Quadri Aruna and Ibrahima Diaw. How you guys doing?
I'm doing very fine. Thanks, Adam.
Yeah, I'm doing good. So hope you're doing good also.
Yeah, Iba, good to see you. So you guys right now, can you tell me, Iba, let's start with you. Tell us where you are at the moment.
Right now, I'm in Montpellier, so south of France, and I'm doing a training camp with some of my so I'm enjoying warm weather here.
Okay. Is home France?
Yeah, it's not my home, but yeah, we decided to go south of France and enjoy the weather and practice, and long time we didn't see each other, so we decided to just to make a camp there.
Quadri, how about you? Where are you right now?
Oh, thank you very much. I'm in Lisbon, in Portugal. I'm home with family and trying to be keeping fit, practicing 4 times in 7 days, resting 3 times. So I'm trying to be the best I can.
That's a different schedule than usual for you during the tournament season, right?
Yes, yes. You know, now it's almost like a holiday, but for me, it's not totally a holiday. You know, I have to get fully prepared for German League, because I think it's going to be a tournament of a different level from Portugal here. So I'm trying my best as much as possible to be fit and get well prepared.
Okay. So in a week, how many days are you training at the moment?
Now I'm training, let's say, 2 times Monday, 2 times Tuesday, 1 time Wednesday with some activities, 1 time Thursday, 2 times Friday, and then activities in the weekend. And when I mean activities, I mean it can be tennis, golf, paddle. And high prices like this. So yeah, I did all this during the lockdown, trying to try new things, new sports, and yeah, try to change my mind a little bit out of the tennis, because the main thing, I qualify for Olympics, so it was nice to lower the pressure a little bit, and then yeah, try some other things.
For Iba's sake, a lot of people are going to know more and more about you between recent performances, but when I first met you, you were playing for France, and there's a pretty exciting story with the World Championships, and I want people to get to know more about your story. Can you tell us about how it came to be that you would represent Senegal and everything from the decision to do that to the qualification process and the excitement when you found out?
Yeah, so for many years, actually, I decided to play for Senegal because came was playing for France, but the competition, the new system, actually play some tournaments, and then I really want to have a international career. You know, I didn't want to have only a career based by playing only for clubs. So then I decided to play for Senegal because my family comes from Senegal, and they were really happy about that. And then, yeah, my first tournament for Senegal was World Championship in Budapest. And that was actually a crazy story because 10 days from the World Championship, I was not going to play because I was not on the list, because I had to wait the approval of ITTF. And so there were a camp in Copenhagen, and I actually couldn't attend to the camp because it was only for players who were playing World Championship. So I actually didn't attend to the camp, and then I didn't practice actually for a week, I think. And then I was playing Fortnite with a friend of mine. And then I never check my emails on my phone normally, and then email popped up, and then it was the director general of ITTF telling me that you are able to play World Championship, and I was playing Fortnite. I had underwear on only in my apartment. And then, okay, I say, guys, I stop and I have to go and play World Championship. And they didn't believe it, you know. They were like, okay, come on, let's play another one, you know. And I called my girlfriend and I say that, okay, I'm going to World Championship. And we had planned this weekend. And she was like, okay, you are joking or what? I said, no, I'm serious. And so while she was booking the flight ticket, I bicycled really fast to pick up my shoes and my racket and everything in the hall. They were in the hall in Copenhagen, and she was booking the flight ticket. And then I packed all my stuff up really fast, and then I asked her brother to drive me to the airport. And all that happened in 2 hours. And in 2 hours, I was in a flight on my way to Budapest.
Wow. Well, I don't know. I know Fortnite, just from Liam Pitchford's very big on Fortnite. I know there are a lot of celebrations. I don't know if you were inspired by Quadri's celebration from the Commonwealth Games by being just in your underwear, but that was a Quadri celebration.
Yes.
Did you see that?
Yes, I saw that. And I was actually, I had the same outfit while I was playing Fortnite.
In honor of Quadri Aruna, every time you play Fortnite, you're thinking of a Commonwealth medalist. You're thinking of someone who's celebrating with shorts off. Wow. Quadri denied that. Quadri, you remember? You and Ojo Onalapo were both saying that it was the other one. But eventually you came clean.
Yeah, that was 8 years ago, I think. It was 2014 or something? I think it was 6 years ago in Glasgow Commonwealth Games. You know, wow. I played in India. We didn't win anything. And luckily we were able to win bronze medal against a very strong team of India. And, you know, it was like a surprise to us because Onolapo won against Ashanta in the deciding, you know. Normally, if Onolapo lost, I was going to play against Anton Amaranch, and playing against him has always been very difficult. So I was only praying that Onolapo won, and surprisingly, he won. So the celebration was somehow.
Amazing. Yeah, in the end. India was the gold medalist next time around, so that's a very strong win.
Yes, yeah. six years. Yes, I think it's 4 years after. 4 years after, we played again in final. So, you know, we both upgraded. They upgraded from fourth place to first place. Then we upgraded from third place to second place. And, of course, it was an amazing performance for us again.
Yeah, doing great things. Well, we'll have more questions about table tennis in Africa and the future of the sport in a bit. I think now might be a good time to get into some of the fan questions. So the first fan question applies to both of you. This comes from Tefan Ma. The question is, how do you keep your mind healthy in these times? Let's start with Iba on this one.
I try to make a lot of activities, as I said before. And I'm lucky that in Denmark, the lockdown was not as big as other countries, you know. So I had the chance to make a lot of activities, tennis, golf, paddle, kayaking. Then I read a lot of books during this period. Try to intellectually work my mind, you know, because it's quite important. And then, yeah. And then after, spend also some quality time with my girlfriend and, yeah, relax. Because as I was really busy, actually, the last period. The last 6 months was really heavy for me. So it was also a good time for me to relax and spend some time with my loved ones. So.
Quadri, how about you? What have you been doing to keep your mind sharp during these times?
Well, I think the last 4 months has been very, very hard and difficult, you know. For some people, it was very, very difficult, totally strange. Okay, for me, I can say, firstly, I was able to get recovered from several injuries. I'm able to stay a lot with the family. It's has always been very, very difficult. The last 3 months, I've been able to know that women are very, very important for the family, because I was able to stay all the time with the kids, the whole family, and I actually realized the kind of work my wife has been doing for years while I'm outside for tournament or training camps or for league matches. Also, it was somehow difficult because I didn't have a table tennis board at home. The lockdown was not so easy here in Portugal. So for about 2.5 months, when the lockdown began, I was unable to practice. So I did mainly physical fitness. And similarly, you know, it is a year that I realized that we are really not going to gain anything. What we will gain this year is to be alive. And the best way to be alive is to keep safe and keep to the rules and regulations. You know, we have always been thinking of playing pro tours. We want to win. I don't want to lose. So for this year, I've always been thinking the best to gain is to be alive, because so many people died already. So for me, I think it's very, very important, okay, to do normal training now, normal physical fitness. At the same time, I'm always thinking of the best way to be very, very safe, because I know something good is coming next year. But for this year, I'm really not setting any kind of goal, because I know it's going to be very difficult to have a tournament or something. So I think it will be very, very important to be safe.
Yeah, as long as I've known you, you've always been very mindful and very grateful for everything. And it's a really good reminder, the fact that we're here and having this conversation. This is something to be thankful for, so, yeah.
Yes, especially when you realize so many people died already. And today we are still alive. We are still hopeful that things will get better. But it is only next year that things will get totally better.
Well, we will see. We're all hopefully doing our part and hoping for the best. Real quickly, in terms of keeping your mind fresh during these times, your kids, how old are your kids now?
First one is 7. Second is 5. White, third is 3.
And can you still carry all 3 of them at the same time when they're pretending that you're a tree?
Of course, why not? You remember some time ago, I carried 3 of them. So I think it is still very, very possible. You know, I'm a man. I'm not a boy.
But they're big. They're almost grown-ups. Well, they're on their way. But I wanted to try with your kids maybe a year ago. But now I don't know, man. I'm not in your shape. I don't know if I could hold all 3 of them at once.
Probably I will try. Immediately after this call, I will try again. Then post it on Instagram for you.
So we've got one more question here before we get into the quizzes. This question is for Iba. It comes from cheese_2. Iba, describe what was going through your head when you beat Quadri to qualify for the Tokyo Olympics.
I made it. Really? I think it's the only thing I had in my mind is that I made it, just a huge relief. And then that was the first part, and the second part was like all the struggles that I had before, the injuries, the hard practices, the sore body, the long travels, the money invested, all that came after, and then I felt like everything was worth it, and I worked so hard for it, and I made it. That's it.
Wow. In terms of your head-to-head history with Quadri before that match, what was your history with Quadri?
I mean, the first time I met you, Aruna, it was in 2010 in German Open.
No, I think it was in World Championships in Russia. I think you were there.
No, I wasn't.
It was Salifu.
It was Salifu. Because I was playing with in the same team with Shegun Toyola and Monde Meroto. So I was playing in the same team with them, and then I went with them to the
German
Open 2010, and they told me, look, this guy, he will become something. And then I look at you. That was the first time, and then after 4 years later, then you won the World Cup, and then you quarterfinal. You won the African Cup, and then after you went to the World Cup, and then Shegun Toyola, remind me, I told you this guy will become something, and then that this is the history, like the first time I met you, and then after that when I really the first conversation I had with you, I think it was I don't remember, but it should be in one pro tour, I think. I don't remember. And then we start talking, and then after he gave me the advice that I should come and play for Africa, and many things will be good for you there, and actually there is a lot of good players there, and also you invite me for the first time, Lagos tournament, when they want to make a big tournament there, so when you invited me there to come and play the Lagos, but then my club didn't want me to go there at that time because we had the meeting or something. So and then after, I mean, you always have been a big brother to me all the time. I had a question and something I needed to know and everything. Then I always go with you, and then it could be the regulation or a tournament or warm up and everything. So you always have been the big brother to me, and this is the kind of relationship we have right now.
And so your way of saying thank you to Quadri for all that is by beating him in a tournament. Just kidding. That's awesome. Congratulations.
I mean, of course, but I want to beat my big brother. This is all the little brother won this, you know?
For sure. And it's a sign of respect. I mean, now you're using his game too. Because now next time he faces you, he knows that he needs to prep even harder. I mean, the level in Africa is going to continue to go up. Quadri's going to have to be stronger. If Quadri's not challenged, I mean, he's just going to get lazy. Soon it'll be 3 days a week. Soon he'll only be carrying 2 children at once. Just down here.
I'm pushing you hard, Aruna.
We will see you next time. Definitely, it's always very tough and hard. You know, the level is actually improving and improving now.
Yeah.
And this is what we really want in Africa. You know, we will definitely get more respect in the international scene. And this is very important for all the African federations.
Quadri, I had a question for you before we get into the quizzes. It just occurred to me, I saw the caricature of you, and your pockets were in. And it reminded me, almost every time I see you play a match, your pockets stuck out like pseudo ears. What's the story with your shorts and the pockets?
You know, brother of Omar Asar is always joking with me with that. He said, whenever my pocket is out, then the opponent will definitely be in big trouble. So he's always like, oh, don't let his pocket come out. Don't let his pocket come out. I actually have no reason for that. You know, it's something natural. It's coming out on its own.
Yeah, because your quads are too big. That's why. That's
why. It's coming out. It's coming out on its own.
There's just not space. Iba's right.
Yes, there's no space. They have to go to come out.
but like you always give attention. You think Omar Asad's brother is right that whenever my pocket is out, then the opponent is in trouble.
Me, I agree. I agree with this.
Iba, when you beat Quadri, were his pockets out at the end of the match?
Not the 3 first set.
Safe.
Not the 3 first set. And then after when the pocket were out, then after I was like, whoa, now I'm in trouble.
You call a timeout immediately, pocket check, and you're like, coach, we got to talk.
Yes, exactly. Change short right now.
Wow. He's going all out, like his pockets. We'll be on the lookout for it when the World Tour or WTT or whatever the next tournament I see you at is. Watch his pockets, Quadri. You guys ready for quiz time?
Yes. Yeah. Let's go.
All right. So, general knowledge, Quadri. Who is the only non-Chinese player to become men's singles world champion this side of the century, post-2000?
Werner Schlager.
Werner Schlager, that is correct. 1-0, Quadri starts strong. All right, Iba, first question for you in the general knowledge, general table tennis knowledge section. Which country collected the women's team title at the 2019 European Championships in Nantes?
Romania?
Correct. 1-1 ties it right back up. Tongue out and everything. Stressful question for the first. They're only getting tougher. Quadri, which country won its first table tennis gold medal at the 2019 African Games?
Algeria.
Algeria it was. 2-1. Quadri back in front by 1. Iba in good spirits here. It's your chance to tie it up. How many players in total have won a table tennis grand slam? Final answer?
2?
Not 2, but 10. 5 men and 5 women. Tough question. Quadri, Iba was ranked outside of the world top 500 in October of 2018. How many positions has he risen in the ITTF world rankings since then?
About 500 positions.
About 500 is a little bit too general for us because it was 895. About 1,000 would be closer. 95.
How much?
964 in October of 2018, and now he's 69 in the world. So, Iba, a chance to tie it up here as it is just 1-2 now for you. Personal knowledge. In what year did Quadri Aruna famously reach the quarterfinals of the Men's World Cup in Dusseldorf, Germany?
2014.
Correct. Tied back up. Quadri laughing because maybe he didn't think those questions were equally difficult. Understandable. Quadri, the lead. In which country did Iba make his senior ITTF World Tour debut in 2016? Final answer. Not Germany. It was Belgium. So tied up at two apiece. Happy to see the head nod there from Iba to make sure that we have the right answer. Iba, Quadri saw off Slovakia's Wang Yang and leader of the Chinese Taipei team, Zhuang Zhiyuan, at the Rio 2016 Olympic Games. Who did he then go on to beat in round four of the men's singles event?
Timo? Timo Boll?
Timo it is. Timo Boll. That is the correct answer. A 3-2 lead. Iba stepping it up. Stepping out in front. We now move on to question number five for Quadri. Quadri, which player did Iba partner to men's doubles success at the 2019 ITTF Challenge Indonesia Open? Hint, the partner was from Thailand.
Supanot. Supanot, left-hander.
It is
I think
not
the name is Supanot.
Supanot. One other player you might know quite well.
Pada I know Sok- him, but the name is... The name is somehow difficult. I know him.
Padasak Tanvilia
Vechukwu. He's left-hander.
Well, the name was the important part for the answer. So, three in a row. You're giving Iba a chance to take a commanding lead here.
The name is not Supanov.
No, it's Padasak. But you guessed that he left. He's left-handed. Supanut is right-handed.
Oh.
I give him half of this one.
Let's see. 2.5 here for Quadri right now for knowing the player but confusing his name. Padasak Ilya Vechakun. Padasak, to make it easy, is your left-handed, the man you're thinking of. Okay. Iba's time. Where did Quadri claim his first ITTF African Championships men's singles title?
Was it Congo?
It was not Congo. It was Mauritius.
Mauritius, yes.
Right. So if I'm not mistaken now, it is 2.5 with the generosity of Iba to 3. Quadri, by my standards, you're down 2-3. Moving on to the next question. In what year did Iba win team gold with France at the European Youth Championships in Terni?
In 2005.
You were definitely in the right millennia. This was 2008. Good guess. Good guess. Okay, Iba, still up by 1 or 0.5 if we count your 0.5 given for partial credit. In Quadri's previous appearance on Ask a Pro Anything in 2015, what surprising pre-match snack did he admit he likes to eat at an event?
Pre-snack for an event.
Final answer?
I would say rice with this red. Oh, the Nigerian eat this also. He can only eat this.
Onigiri. Japanese rice balls. That's what you're... No.
I love eating cookies before match because it's a little bit not so solid like the other food. So eating some cookies before match is so much more better for me so that I can be able to move my body during the match.
Cookies was the answer that we were looking for. Cookies. But I like, as soon as you pulled out the rice, I thought, there's no way you're going to get partial credit on this one.
Yeah, but you can admit that you eat this in the tournament, right?
That's why it was so surprising. We couldn't believe it. Quadri Aruna, the fit warrior, Quadri Aruna, eats cookies before matches. Fascinating.
I will start to eat cookies now if I can have your love.
Have you already graduated to birthday cake? Are you eating birthday cake before matches now?
Not yet.
We'll find a good excuse for you to do that. We'll try to celebrate something soon enough when there's a tournament. All right, so just 0.5 behind. Still, let's say a 2-3 ball game. General knowledge we move on to now. Quadri, in the hit movie The Matrix, what color pill does Neo take?
I didn't watch that before, so let me say blue.
For a guy who didn't watch it, that is not a bad guess. It was the other pill. It was the red pill, a dose of truth at all costs, but not a bad guess, Quadri. 50-50 with the red and the blue, and if you haven't seen the film, not a bad guess. Okay. I recommend the film, by the way. If you have a chance,
me too.
I think worth watching. You feel the same, Iba?
Yes, I feel the same.
Wow. There is no spoon, Quadri. There is no spoon. Right. Iba, general knowledge question for you. What is the capital of Australia?
Melbourne?
It is not Melbourne.
Is that Melbourne?
It's not. It's a lesser-known city internationally. It is Canberra. Mm. I rolled the R like it's a Spanish Canberra, but it's Canberra, maybe.
Okay.
Good guess, though. Good guess. More popular city internationally, definitely Melbourne. All right. So still a close game here right now. 2-3, Quadri, a chance to tie it up. General knowledge, second question. What is the tallest mountain in the world?
No idea.
Final answer?
No idea.
No idea. It is not no idea. It is Mount Everest.
Yes.
8,848 meters tall, Mount Everest. The Himalayas. Nepal and China, the border. If you have a chance and you need some training, carry your kids up that. Give your wife a break from all the work she does when you're at tournaments. All right, still 2-3. Iba, a lead, but not a comfortable lead, just by one. A chance now to break the game open.
Come on.
Which amphibious animal or creature is known for the fact it can go without sleep for months at a time?
Months at a time.
Final answer?
I don't know. I would say a camel, maybe.
A camel. Maybe the wording here was tough to hear, but it is not a camel. It is a bullfrog.
Okay.
No problem. Next time you have the opportunity to ride a bullfrog, you will remember that it might be asleep for months at a time, and you will choose a camel instead.
Okay.
All right. Fun guess, though. Yes. Quadri just gave no idea on the last one, so I think. All right. Still 2-3. Quadri, your chance to tie it up. Who is the best-selling rap artist of all time?
50 Cent.
Ooh, not a bad guess. Final answer?
Ja Rule.
I completely... Ja Rule. Oh, man. I was happy. I sort of ruined that by saying final answer, but hearing Ja Rule was even better. Awesome. It was Eminem.
I was about to say it. Oh, my God.
46.5 million hip-hop album sales as of May 29th.
What?
10 million ahead of second-place Tupac Shakur, or Tupac, as he was known when he stopped being a backup dancer for Digital Underground. Wow. Oh, I was going to give you a clue, Quadri, and I forgot. Would you have guessed it if I told you that his palms are sweaty?
Maybe.
That's okay. Still down 2-3. Iba, a big chance right now to seal it. If you get this one right, you are guaranteed to beat Quadri once again, but this time not to qualify for the Olympic Games, but to bigger. A better score and ask a pro anything at home edition presented by Andro. Which male football or soccer player has won the most Ballon d'Or?
Sadly, Lionel Messi.
That is the correct answer. Sadly or not, you have secured yourself the victory with 4 points already coming into the 10th question. Clearly a football fan. Well played, sir. Well played. Quadri, for pride and to beat the future of people who will come in lower than you on the leaderboard, question number 10. And this might be the toughest of them all. Which baseball team won its first World Series title in 2019?
I don't follow baseball.
Final answer? You sure you don't follow baseball, or do you change your mind about that? Suddenly you follow baseball?
I don't follow.
Just for fun, Iba, can you guess?
No, I have no idea.
The funny thing is I did follow baseball for a long time, and I didn't even realize this was a team because I haven't followed baseball in that long.
Okay.
It was the Washington Nationals.
Okay.
Known as the Montreal Expos, who I knew by that name.
Okay.
I guess we've all got catching up to do, but table tennis, you know our table tennis fine enough, so we're in good shape. The Quadri, a 2 and a 2.5 on the IBA generosity scale. General knowledge, question number 10. Iba, a chance to tie up the bottom of the leaderboard. Peter Jean Hernandez is an American singer-songwriter known by what famous name?
Peter Jean Hernandez.
Wow.
I have no idea. Peter Jean Hernandez.
Final answer?
I have no idea. I don't.
Well, it might, small clue, it won't count at this point. He was born in Hawaii.
Unfortunately, I have no idea.
That's okay. I'll give it to you. Actually, Uptown Funk will give it to you. But Bruno Mars. It's Bruno Mars.
Really? Oh my God.
Yeah.
I had no idea.
Neither did I.
Yeah.
So final score, Iba 4, Quadri 2.5. All right. Well, that was a lot of fun. We've got two more questions for you guys, fan questions. This one is for you, Quadri. The question is from Kid Nashito. It says, what did you feel when you won the point of the year against Zhang Jike in 2014?
I was so happy. And similarly, I was so surprised because there are other better players than I then. So for me, it was some kind of motivation to even work much more harder.
Well, the next question is for both of you. A question from Shui Ping. The question is, Africa, well, I guess it's more of a statement, Africa will be successful in table tennis in the future. Tell us the steps you imagine will make this happen. Let's start with you, Iba.
In my opinion, for me, the most important is to have to train coaches, to bring them home, and then to have a well education outside table tennis, of course, is important, and also in table tennis to have structure, to learn them the technique, the basics, and everything. Because I have been to Senegal in November, and then I mean, when I present table tennis to the kids, they were really, I mean, they were surprised to discover a new sport, and they were really so happy and they wanted to play table tennis. So we actually gave table to schools, and then kids were playing and playing and playing and playing, and they had a lot of energy, you know. And I feel like if there is coaches in school who can learn them how to play table tennis, we will have a lot of players. I think table tennis is really fun to play. Everybody can play anywhere. I mean, we also saw that during the lockdown, many people played on tables and with pans and everything. So it's like everybody loves to play table tennis, and I feel like if the coaches have some I can see that you trained it only on the snakes on this table. No, but I really think that if there is coaches in Africa, and I think they can teach many players to play table tennis and then to show them table tennis. And actually, this is why Nigeria and Egypt, they are really successful in table tennis, because there is many coaches there, you know. So I hope that I invite all the African federation to try to train their coaches.
Awesome. Awesome. Very valuable words. Happy to hear that. Quadri, how about you? What are your thoughts?
He's totally right and correct. Just like you said, youth developmental program is very, very important and crucial to development of African table tennis players. Also, I think more tournaments should be staged regularly. I mean, regional, and after they can always play like they play here in Europe and other parts of the world. Like this junior tournament, this junior cycle and cadet cycle, you know, they can not just be training and training. They have to practice that into tournament. And also, I think a lot of funding is required, you know. For many countries in Africa, government is not doing a lot. So I think companies, different individuals, for example, in Nigeria, government was not really supporting me. It was Waidi and Ita Oshodi who actually came to my rescue. And we need a lot of these kind of individuals in Africa, and companies also. So if sponsors can come in, then it means everything will come. So just like you said also, it is very important we give more knowledge to our coaches, because coaches are very, very important. They are the one to impact knowledge on these younger ones. So I think we are talking about years from now, you know. Things will definitely change if these things can come to pass.
Well, I think the tough times will come to pass, and players like yourselves and several others that we've seen from Africa coming up in the world will continue to inspire people. So this is good. From your lips to the ears of the people who can make these things happen, I'm excited to see Africa continue to rise, and hopefully fewer years than more, as everyone's improving in the game. So good to hear. Well, those are the questions, guys. It's been a lot of fun. Anything you'd like to say to your fans before we go? Quadri, why don't we start with you on this one?
For me, fans are very, very important, you know. In this 3.5 months ago, we have realized that they are the most important thing in sport. You know, they are always in the hall cheering us up. And these days we are just playing alone, especially if you have been able to play without spectators in the hall. Like here in Portugal, we play without spectators. It was somehow dull, you know. The motivation was not of the highest order. So they are very important. So they should keep supporting and cheering for us.
Cool. And Iba, anything you'd like to say to your fans?
Yeah, I would like to say, first of all, to stay healthy and keep being safe, and then follow the regulations that their governments are putting in, you know. So, yeah, and then as Aruna said, they are really important for the sport. Table tennis without supporters is not table tennis anymore. And we of course need them to make some show and to make some great table tennis. And we also say the we change the way our way of playing when there is supporters actually. So yeah, we do it also a little bit for them. So yeah, I would say be safe and come back as soon as the World Tour is back also.
Alrighty, well, thanks a bunch. There you have it, guys. It's been another fun episode of Ask a Pro Anything at Home Edition presented by Andro. And we look forward to having you back soon. Quadri, Iba, great to see you guys.
Yes, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone, for watching. And hopefully we will meet very soon.
Yes.
Take care. High fives.
Yeah.